Good morning, children. Today we are going to see biology, getting to know plants chapter. Already we discussed about the parts of the plant like stem, roots, leaves. Today we are going to discuss about the next part of a plant, that is your flowers. First, the plants which give flowers are called flowering plants. Those which do not give flowers are non-flowering plants. It means the certain plants which has the potential to produce flowers. Example, rose, jasmine. There are certain plants who cannot produce flowers. Example, ferns, pines and crotons. Okay, so the plants may be available in different sizes, shape and attractive colors, and they have their fragrance means smell. They have some kind of sweet smell in them. Okay, like flowers of grass and weeds will not have so smell in them, and they are very tiny. Tiny means small in size. And we eat flowers of certain plants. So the flower is also an edible part of a plant. Edible means eatables. Banana, pumpkin and drumstick. So in these plants the flowers are edible. Okay, so how does a flower look? It has an attractive color. Okay, so today's class we are going to see what are all the parts present in a flower. Still now we saw the flower as a part of a plant. But in today's class, you will get to know what are the parts present inside a flower also. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a flower. Let us take it as hibiscus. And I'm going to cut it into equal halves. I'm going to take a cross section of the flower. What is meant by cross section? Cross section means, example, I'm drawing here an apple. If I cut this apple in the center exactly into halves, I would get two pieces of apple. Right? So this is called cross section, cutting it in the center so that what is present inside will be visible. Okay, so I'm going to take a flower, example hibiscus flower, and I'm cutting it. I'm going to have a cross section of it. Cross section means cutting it in the center. I could see the beautifully colored petals. The surfaces of your flower, which is very attractive, which is colorful in nature, will be called by the name as petals. Rose petals, you would have come across this word, rose petals. So the petals means in a flower, the attractive part, that is called the colorful part, is called your petals. Okay, and in the bottom you will have a green color part, that is your sepals, which will have the attachment to the stem of the plant, because you will have, you could find the flower attached to the stem or the branches of leaves, right? So the part through which the flower is attached will be green in color. Yes, that is called as sepals. Let us have this as one combined pair. So what is petals? Petals means the attractive, colorful part in a flower. sepals means the green color part through which the flower is attached to the plant. Okay, so always you keep in your mind, in a flower you have four parts. In that, the first one is petals and sepals. They both will be combinedly called, will form a pair. Easy to remember. Petals and sepals. Petals means attractive colorful part. Sepals means the green color part attached to the stem. Okay, over. So next remaining is pistil and stamens. If you see inside a flower, you could see the pollen grains, that is the yellow color substance attached in the flower, which will be carried away by the insects during pollination or for dispersion also. This, I think you have come across the word pollen grains in your lower class. So pollen grains means the small yellow color substance present in the flower, like small seeds. Okay, so that part where you could see in the center of the flower, there you can find the pistil and stamen. Okay, so the stamen and pistil will be present in the center part of the flower. Okay, how to differentiate between a pistil and stamen? Okay, for that, the pistil is the innermost part in the flower, surrounded by the stamens. Okay, so in the centermost part of a flower, you could find the pistil and stamens. To identify the difference between them, the innermost one is pistil, surrounded by stamens. Okay, children? Alright. Now, let us see how does a stamen look. What are present in the stamen and what is the use of a stamen? Okay. So, if you see here, the stamens will be surrounded and inside the innermost one is your pistil. So, in the stamen, you have two parts. Okay, the stem like one is your filament and the top portion is anther. Both anther and filament together will give your stamens. Yes, so in this image, can you see here the top portion is anther, the bottom one is filament. So the filament will be looking like a very thin wire, like a thread it will be. And on the top you could find the anther. Anther is nothing but a small portion of a flower where the pollen grains carried by the birds or air will be present. Okay. So in the centermost part of the flower, you will have the stamens and pistil. How to differentiate stamens and pistil? Pistil is the innermost one, surrounded by the stamens. Stamen is comprised of anther and filament. Anther is the top portion, filament is the bottom thread-like structure. Now, let us see the innermost part, that is the pistil. So the pistil is only responsible for the... So pistil is the place where the reproduction happens in a plant, that is from a flower to a fruit. Okay, so how come a flower is transformed into a fruit? When the pollen grains come and fall on the stigma, it will be taken inside. So that is why in the pistil you have three segments: stigma, style and ovary. Okay, so this is again the where you could see the sepals of the plants like this. This is the stem.
sorry for my bad drawing. So until this it gets over your pistil, and this is the continuation of your stem, as you could see here. Yes, so the pistil, it continues, you could see the sepals at the bottom. Okay, so you could see the stigma, style and ovary in a pistil. So again I have taken a cross section of the pistil and drawn here. Can you see here the stigma? So stigma is the place where the pollen grains will come and fall. Stigma. So once a pollen grain comes and falls on the stigma, it is allowed to pass inside through a tube like structure. That tube like structure is called by the name style. So the pollen grains will go inside like this, and you will have the ovary at the bottom. So when I take the cross section of the pistil, I could see the ovules present inside the ovary. Ovules are nothing but like small bead like structures present inside the ovary. These ovules, when it comes in contact with the pollen grains, they start to mature and the flower gets converted into a fruit. Okay children, so the ovules will mature and it will form into a fruit. So coming back here, what and all we have in a flower? The first pair is petals and sepals. Petals are the colorful, attractive part. Sepals are the green part attached to the stem, and inside you will have the pistil and stamens. So I can better tell it as pistil is the female part and stamens is the male part. Okay, so what did we have in the stamens? The stamens, you will have a small tube like or thread like structure, that is your filament, and in the anther you will have the pollen grains. Okay, the pollen grains will be present in the anther. So stamens is the male part of a flower. So pistil is the female part of a flower. So in a pistil, what do you have? You have stigma, style and ovary. I have drawn here how a cross section of a pistil looks. Yes, so the stigma, as the name tells, stigma means a sticky part. Okay, so in the stigma, the pollen grains from the stamen will fall down. It gets stuck. And style is the small tubular structure, tube-like structure. The pollen grains stuck on the stigma will enter through the style and reach the ovary. So the ovary is filled with ovules. Ovules means like small beads like structure present inside the pistil. This ovule and the pollen grains get in contact and the maturity, it gets matured and the flower is converted into a fruit. Not all the flowers which we see gets changed into a fruit. There are certain flowers which changes into a fruit. So that is because of the presence of stamens and pistil in it. All the flowers will have the four parts. Petals and sepals is the first pair. Second pair is pistil and stamens present inside the flower. Okay children, so with this I would like to stop, and your chapter is over. If you have any doubt in this chapter, kindly contact me. Thank you children.